negative as a result of agriculture. But joining us to answer three big questions that our viewers have sent in is one of the finest minds in Indian agriculture and has long experience in Indian agriculture, Professor Y.K. Alag. He is now Vice Chairman of the Sardar Patel Institute of Economic and Social Research, has been at the Planning Commission, has been a minister, and specializes in agriculture. Thank you, Professor Alag, very much for joining us. The first question that we'd like to put to you is, can the government in any way stop or do anything to control this rise in food prices?
Pranay, it can. Basically, the only real freedom it has is through imports, because in the short run, domestic supplies are going to be restricted.
Yes.
But we have to remember, as you pointed out, that the price rise is largely in a few commodities, like vegetables,
right,
like pulses, and to an extent even edible oil. Vegetables, I don't think there is much of freedom in terms of import. As far as edible oils are concerned, we are already importing about 90% of our edible oils. And pulses, we are importing around 30%. I think this right. year, if you take the decisions into account, we would be importing around 40%. So there is very limited play, but we should try and control these prices. However, we do need a perspective. If you look at the whole of the last year, the increase in wholesale prices is very much in terms of the overall price index. If you look up till the end of March,
right,
it
right.
is subsequently because that prices have increased more and consumer prices have increased even more.
Can tell me, Professor Alag, you've studied Indian agriculture for several decades now. You've seen what happens in drought. Describe to us what a farmer goes through facing drought, the hardship that he goes through.
There are two kinds of farmers. One are basically very, very poor farmers up in the hills or in drought regions. And for them, this is really bad, because the real decision is that they have to let some of their cattle die. It is as bad as that. They have no reserves, they have no water, and yep. these are very uncomfortable decisions.
And they go into to money lenders?
They go to money lenders, but again you need collateral.
Right.
And so they run down their assets. This has been extensively studied, and animals are one of that run down.
Right.
For
right.
the others, a very large majority of farmers, first in the dryland regions, it means that crops wither away. In the beginning, we thought that there could be re-sowing. Now that's almost impossible.
Right.
Or if you've grown an inferior cereal, you just get a little bit of fodder and hardly any grain.
Right.
So in the regions where it hit, it's bad.
Right, sir. Our second question that we'd like to put to you tonight is, how much will this kind of a drought, if there's no revival, and as you say, it's looking too late now, how much will it slow down India's agricultural GDP and overall growth rate this year?
Tubar.com.